My new book, which is forthcoming in October 2019 from Cinco Puntos Press, is called A Peculiar Kind of Immigrant Son. And it's a book of short stories in which the stories are linked together. So you see different characters in different stories. And it's about Mexican-American diaspora, starting at the border from El Paso, but then also going to places like Connecticut with Mexican-American characters, and New York and other places as well, and how the sense of home is lost, and what does it do to these characters to leave your community, but also to try to come back to it, and the different issues within families, you know, that happens when this occurs. It's at the end, you'll see in this collection, there is somewhat of a magical realist, perhaps an experimental part of it. And so as the reader goes through this collection, I hope the reader will be transported to another place that is also questioning and asking this question of where do we belong, what is our home, and what happens when we leave our home and then come back to it. So my take on the magical realism, and in my stories in this coming collection, A Peculiar Kind of Immigrant Son, is really to play with time and perspective. And so a certain character, he's actually experiencing time in multiple ways at the same time that the reader is reading this character. Just as if we're living in the past right now, at the same time as we're here in the present right now, at the same time that we're also thinking about what are we going to do an hour from now. And this is all going through our minds. And so this is not something necessarily, for example, that Marquez ever did, play with time in the same story. And so the last story in the collection, or the second to last story, Eternal Return, which is a Nietzschean concept, is about this character going back to the border, but also has a present moment in which he is discussing something with who he thinks is his grandmother, but his grandmother's dead. And yet he's having a real discussion with her, yet he's also being transported in between walls, in between matter as well. And so he's traveling in his mind as much as he is traveling in the present. And so that's this concept of playing with time and perspective is where the collection ends. It's in many ways something that Joyce did, you know, James Joyce. When you read Ulysses, you know, you read Leopold Bloom, and he's everywhere in his mind. In the present, he is everywhere. He's not just here in the present. He's also thinking about what happened decades ago. He's thinking about what happened yesterday. He's thinking about what will happen in a few hours or in 3 days. So this sense of playing with time and perspective is what I'm focusing on in my work, at least toward the end of this collection, because the beginning is very much of a realist stories that eventually transport you somewhere else.